Retinal sequelae of COVID-19 infection and its management, a consecutive case series treated at our hospital. Our cases can be classified as infections secondary to immunosuppression from COVID and its treatment, and included endogenous endophthalmitis, candida retinitis, choroidal abscess, and mucormycosis causing central retinal artery occlusion. Post-viral sequelae including acute macular neuroretinopathy and paracentral acute middle maculopathy, bilateral prefoveal hemorrhages, and post-fever retinitis. Treatment-related adverse effects including central serous retinopathy associated with steroid use and voriconazole-related visual symptoms. Our first patient was a 46-year-old male who presented in October last year with symptoms of endophthalmitis of 4 weeks duration that started during his COVID infection, at which time he also developed diabetes. He was treated with pars plana vitrectomy and intravitreal antimicrobial agents. Vitreous microbiology was negative. He was placed on oral voriconazole and ciprofloxacin with complete resolution at 6 weeks. Our second endogenous endophthalmitis was a 72-year-old male who was referred in July this year with features of endophthalmitis for 6 weeks that started during his COVID infection. He underwent vitrectomy with intravitreal antimicrobial agents, and vitreous microbiology was positive for Aspergillus flavus. He was placed on oral voriconazole with rapid initial improvement but subsequent worsening, and he is still under treatment. In October last year, we had a 57-year-old male who came for routine fundus screening as he had developed candidemia during his COVID infection. He was on intravenous fluconazole at this time. Evaluation revealed multiple candida retinitis lesions in the right eye. We switched him from fluconazole to voriconazole because of its superior vitreous bioavailability. There was initial improvement with subsequent worsening, so he was treated with intravitreal antimicrobial agents with rapid resolution and complete clearing of all lesions at 12 weeks after the injection. Now, invasive candidiasis and candidemia has been reported with COVID-19 infection, but candida retinitis has not yet been reported. This was a 59-year-old lady who presented in December last year with blurring of vision for 4 weeks. There was a large choroidal abscess with inflammatory deposits. These symptoms and signs had started during her COVID infection 4 weeks prior to presentation, at which time she had also developed diabetes. She was investigated for this lesion and all results were negative. Based on the clinical picture, she was placed on antitubercular therapy with rapid resolution at 6 weeks and complete clearing at 6 months. Systemic TB with COVID-19 infection has been reported, but not ocular tuberculosis. It is speculated that COVID-19 can activate dormant TB by altering host immunity. In May this year, we had a 68-year-old male with complaints of red eye and vision drop. And this had started 2 weeks after his COVID infection. He was on steroids when he came to us. We placed him on an additional tablet, levofloxacin, and investigated him for this subretinal lesion. Toxoplasma IgG was positive in the serum, and so tablet Bactrim was added to his treatment. And at 6 weeks, there was complete resolution of the lesion, but we still do not know the etiology for this. In January this year, a 32-year-old male complained of sudden onset of scotoma in his right eye for the last 3 days. He had recovered from COVID-19 4 months prior. All his other investigations were negative. There was a deep retinal grayish white lesion in the right eye corresponding to outer retinal layers disruption on the OCT. Additionally, there were hyperreflective lesions in the superficial retina on the OCT, with underlying shadowing. Similar lesions were seen in the other eye. So he appeared to have right eye symptomatic AMN and bilateral asymptomatic PAM. There are only two reports of these lesions in association with COVID-19 infection. In June this year, there was a 32-year-old lady who complained of sudden deterioration of vision in both eyes due to pre-foveal hemorrhages. She had Pseudomonas sepsis that she had contracted during her COVID infection, and at this time she had severe thrombocytopenia. 8 weeks from onset, the pre-foveal hemorrhages had resolved completely with visual improvement. This was a 71-year-old male who presented in April this year with painless blurring of vision in the right eye for 20 days. He'd had COVID infection 3 months prior and then had some fever following that. He had been investigated by the referring physician for the retinitis, and all investigations were negative. He had been on doxycycline for a week with no benefit. We saw him with retinitis and vitreous cells and haze, and he was placed on oral steroids with rapid resolution at 1 week and complete resolution at 8 weeks. This was a 24-year-old lady complaining of vision drop in the left eye for 10 to 15 days. She had been on oral steroids for the last 3 weeks for her COVID-19 management. Evaluation revealed a serous detachment at the macula, and this resolved following discontinuation of steroids. In November last year, we had a 40-year-old male complaining of multiple visual symptoms for 3 weeks. He was on IV voriconazole for management of systemic aspergillosis that he had contracted during his COVID infection. His medication review did not reveal any other medications responsible for the visual symptoms. Ocular evaluation and visual functions were within normal limits. We made a diagnosis of voriconazole-induced visual disturbance. The dose of voriconazole was reduced with improvement of his symptoms within a week. However, the dose had to be stepped up later with recurrence of the visual symptoms. So voriconazole-induced visual symptoms should be important diagnosis in COVID patients, because many of these patients are on voriconazole for associated fungal infections, especially when the symptoms are associated with normal ocular evaluation and objective evaluation of visual functions. Thank you.